No! Hey guys, what's up? It's Long D. And yep, I have succumbed to the seeming heroine that is Minecraft. Yeah, I've been playing for a little while now. And I thought I'd make a video for everyone just to kind of show you what I've done. If you guys like it, or want to see more or anything, just let me know. But I'm probably only going to do one for now. Because I know, kind of a thing right now, and for good reason, actually, you know. Before I start talking about it too much, I won't actually jump into the game, so hold on a second here. fixed my camera issue. Turns out that, you know, sometimes logic is your best friend, so if the tripod only, you know, swivels one direction, then what you do is you just flip the camera around on it, so then it swivels the other direction, so now I can compensate for that weird, how I mounted my TV wrong. Anyway, alright, let's jump in here. And just to let everyone know, I've been playing on peaceful mode. For some reason, it says my world's 0 megabytes. I don't know why that is. I've been playing on peaceful mode because I'm more of a builder. Like, I like building and collecting things. But that's one of the things, is that if you guys would want it, then I would switch over to, normal or hard mode or whatever. Not easy, because I don't want it to be on easy. So normal or hard, and kind of, like, start trying to defend myself at night and things as I'm doing stuff, but I want to give you, and it kind of stinks, and it's nighttime right now, because I want to show you guys some stuff in the daylight, but, anyway, just put this in here. Okay, so, just want to show you some of the stuff that I've done so far. This is kind of what I made, well, here, let me start this way. This was my first house right here that I made, it's pretty cool, it's by the water. I was lucky that I started next to a source of water like this, and there's, you know, infinite source in the center, so if I grab an empty bucket, I can just jump in and be like, whoop, and just, I got infinite water source there, so it's really cool. What else? So yeah, this is my first house that I made right here, just this little shanty, and I've kind of, since then I've had to dig down here for minerals. Yeah, not really had to, but since I've been working on other stuff right around the area, this just seemed like the easiest way to kind of plow into stuff, to gather what I need. I forgot what I did down here, what the hell? Oh yeah, this goes around by the water. Or does it? No way, no, it's a dead end, never mind. I already explored in there. There's nothing in there yet. I haven't done any digging or anything. But yeah, this game's really fun. I'm sure basically everybody's watching this has tried it by now. If you haven't, give it a shot, and I'm sure you'll be impressed that you could ever find something like this, with this concept, entertaining. Because I was mad surprised, but then again, you know, if I can be entertained by Mafia Wars, then I can be entertained by this, I suppose, right? So I just admitted that I played Mafia Wars. Anyway, so this is my first house. Made a little fireplace. You can go in there, that's what you see up top, as I try to make it, you know, kind of look realistic, or as realistic as I could, make a smokestack sticking up there. Let's see, a chest here. I moved all my stuff over here since I'm working right in the area, and I do actually plan on getting rid of this at some point, just demolishing it and filling in the land. I've already started right here. I used to have, I think it's right here. Just see if you guys go fast. I used to have a little underground, little underground atrium that I filled in. I had some trees growing in there and stuff, and it's kind of neat, but didn't really, come on, there we go. Filled that in, don't want it anymore. And then I had an escape passage, because I did start playing on normal, and I turned it off because I decided I wanted to get into some more heavy building stuff and not be bothered by anything. But, yeah. And this used to be on my little escape hatch. It used to have a roof. So that in case, you know, any creepers, like, lined up at the door, I could come over here and get out without too much trouble. But yeah, that was my first house. And since then, I kind of branched out. My underground atrium used to be right here. That's just some tree that's on fire. I kind of set it on fire as a beacon. This used to be, like, kind of a viewing area to my underground atrium that I filled in, and then I... God damn pigs. I'm gonna hoe you to death. Fuck out of here. I hate how the animals, like, flock to sources of light, it almost seems, because every time it turns to night, now I don't want pork. Come on. I'm gonna be slapping stuff with a piece of pork. Every time it turns to night, they just flock to all my torches or whatever, so that might be an interesting way to lure some, you know, somewhere. Anyway, but yeah, I filled that in, and then I made a sort of, like, a little patch of, you know, farmland. Oh, it's turning into day, almost. Yeah, it's almost there. But yeah, this is kind of a quick, get that, there we go. So, I set this up, so this is my little, down there. And is that ready? I think that's ready. Hold on a sec. Yep. Have that. My little crop field. That I made this thing, which is sort of like a, you know, irrigation system that I made. Can't jump with it. Sorry, I just want to see the cell phone going off. Just sorry. Show you how I made it. So, basically, let me jump up here and show you. Oh, pigs are everywhere. Okay. So, the way it works is there's water stored in here, in the top, over the center, over the middle block. So, these are 3x3. They're 9 squares apiece. So, there's water hovering over a source that I put up here with buckets, over the top of every one. And so, what you do is, like, when your crops grow or they die or whatever, and you're ready to, irrigate the land again, you just basically come over and you just, you know, chop out the center block. And that way it works as kind of like a sprinkler system. See? So you just chop those out. I don't care about the rest of the crops, I can replant. But yeah. And then, from the sides here, you just, hoe the land, till it. And then as soon as you're done, you just grab a stopper and just, block it back up. Water goes away and you're ready to plant again. So I thought that was pretty cool. I'm actually surprised I was able to think of that one. But I like the fact that I did. It's pretty cool. If you hear anything in the background, someone's taking a shower right now, I think. I don't know who it is. Could be Satan. He likes to sneak in here from time to time. Anyway, here's kind of my main base of operations that I'm working on right now. It's a tower I made. Too much time there's left. We got 6 minutes yet. Excuse me for the lines across the screen. It's something to do with, I don't know, the gamma or whatever. But yeah, sorry that I can't help that. I don't know why I showed up now. I didn't show up with the games. But yeah, this is my base of operations right here. And it took me a while to get done. I'll kind of do a, side to side. So I have, it's four spires, and there's a central place there. Here's my, here. This is, actually, I made a thing that I'm going to expand on, but basically what this is a place where I can easily kill monsters. So my plan to expand on this, basically, is just to lure monsters in here, and then you have them run through a strip of fire like that, and then eventually, I think, that's not the direction, this direction will lead off into longer hallways, so I'm going to expand over here. And, with doors and switches and things like that. So you can basically set them on fire, lure them in the hallway, shut the door, and then you kill them. That's how I want to get rid of the creepers eventually, so I can start collecting gunpowder, excuse me. And clearing out more mining areas. But yeah, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, yeah, that's that. So I want to touch on that before I climb up. Yeah, here's my... Oh. And just in case you're wondering, the things that are burning up there are redstone. So I was able to make a portal into the slip, I think it's called, the nether, the slip, whatever you want to call it, hell, doesn't matter. And so I put those at the top, so those burn forever. And it's a lot easier than getting, hunks of tree and putting them up there and setting them on fire, because you got to make sure they don't spread. And it's just a pain in the butt. But, yeah, those function as my signal fires down on this level. And then, because as you can see, the tower stretches up above the canvas of the clouds. Here's the central tower. We've got support spires on the four corners. And then this, not really sure what I'm going to do with this. I put this up here just temporarily so I could finish these two. But I actually kind of like it, and I might expand on that design and maybe start stacking them. Maybe make one more right where this is on each side. So each side would have one strip like that, and then one more strip where the other stone, I'm going to call it slate, where the other slate starts on the spire. I thought that might look kind of cool, because then there'd be a gap in the center, and so you kind of see through it when you're close or far away or whatever. But yeah, let me take up a tour of the central tower real fast. Got a ladder up there. Oop. I gotta say I have to jump. So I think I put glass down there. Yeah, I did. So I put glass down there. It's a cloud. It's passing through because did the render distance set to short. And that's what the heck? There's another one there. Had the render distance set to short because I kind of like the way it looks. I can't have it set to far. And the game doesn't lag, but I like the way this looks better. The fog looks pretty cool, I think. But anyway, yeah, so here's the top, and I also have signal fires up here so that, if I'm really far away and there aren't a lot of clouds floating through the sky, then I can see where I am. If I set it to far and I get lost. That's that. I might expand on this eventually, too, kind of make a little terrace or something like that. I don't really see the point now, though, because it's basically finished. All I need is see, how many pieces of glass did I put on there? Is it just the four? No, it's just the three, actually. So, yeah, I just need three more pieces of glass, and I can finish this corner and have that done. And, yep. So that's that. Jump back down the center here. Yeah, really slow going back down. So you can see, I'm trying to keep this video as just one part, so I think I have 15 minutes. I don't want to risk it, though, so I might cut it off here in a second. But yeah, oh, we're at the bottom. And so here is where I'm making the church steeple thing. Not really a church steeple, but just kind of a cool structured building. And so what I started doing is I started building off right here, off the side. I think I'm only going to have one of these. So this is going to be the entranceway, like that. You know, you're going to... I don't know what I'm going to put in here exactly, but yeah, I'm working on expanding that. I don't think I have any more slate right now. I think I'm making some, actually, down there in the stove. But yeah, that's going to be that. That should be pretty cool. That over there is just my original support, and since I made this thing, and I'm actually going to turn this into, like, rafters, which actually... I'm going to put a couple down real fast. Boop. 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 Yeah, real exciting, huh? I thought I'd finish this real fast. I got the time. I got a few minutes left. So that's that. And so, that's done. Okay, so yeah, that's going to be my beam. I have some rafters up here, which actually, that's kind of cool now that I think about it. It's the first time I really kind of visualized it in my head how that's going to look. But yeah, that should be cool. And I want to give it, you know, the appearance of like a cathedral. Not necessarily pertain to anything religious, but I like the look, so I decided to do that. How much time do I have left? A couple minutes here. Let me just show you a couple of the other things I've been working on so far. I'll climb back down here. Hold on. But where is it? I think it's that one. There we go. Yeah, this first house, kind of backtracking here. I plan to expand this road because what I'm doing, call me insane, or say I have no life, but this is kind of the joy I find in this game, is that it just kind of gives you a small set of tools, and you're in an open world, and you can just kind of do what you want to. You can build what you want. It's basically all you can do. You know, it's like imagination. It's what my friends and I used to do when The Elder Scrolls III Morrowind came out. There were a lot more options in that game than there were in Oblivion as far as goes on, like single player role playing experience, like things you can use your imagination with. But yeah, enough about that. So over here what I'm doing is I'm actually building a forest, because I am not around a forest right now, obviously. What's that over there? It's just grass. So I'm building a forest, and I've been planting trees, and see, there's actually, these are new trees that have just grown, thankfully. There's one over there still waiting to grow. But yeah, these have grown, and what I'm doing is, can I get through there? Nope. Nope. There we go. So I'm making this forest, and what I'm doing is actually building as much as I possibly can, as true to it as I possibly can, building kind of a replica or a reimagining of Dracula's castle from, you know, kind of a mix, I'm going to say a mix of between, you know, Bram Stoker's envisionment of his castle and of the Symphony of the Night castle, and that's what's going to go up here on this giant plateau. And the funny thing about this plateau is that I've actually had to build the plateau because it didn't start out big enough, so I've actually spent a lot of time filling this in from down there, basically. See, I still have that, and I still have a little bit of work to do over here. So we gotta fill all this in, like, and basically this is how I've been doing it since I have like one more minute. So what I've been doing is I just drop down, I go collect a shitload of dirt with my diamond shovel, then I just kind of backtrack along here, and that's the fastest way you can possibly fill this in. And you get to the, oops, get, oh, come on. Get to the end, turn around, do it again, hopefully I have some more dirt left. I do, thankfully. A lot more, actually. So let me fill in one more row, and then I'll bid you guys adieu for now, which is German. Someone was kind enough to let me know. I had no idea. That was a long time ago, actually. That was when Programmer and I were still doing the Way of the Samurai videos. But yeah, I'll kind of step out of here for now. But yeah, that's what I've been doing here, and I actually want to expand this a bunch more to the side, because I'm going to need some more room to work with. I don't really think this is the proper length of a giant, you know, monstrosity of a castle. And obviously I'm going to be expanding this backwards, too. Probably to about right there, where that pit starts over there. See where the holes are in the mountain? And yeah, that'll be good. But I'm running out of time. I've got a few seconds, so I'm going to cut it now. Here's my portal to hell, you guys. Take it easy. And if you like it, comment and tell me about it. Goodbye.